Welcome to Your Voice. I'm Julia Locandy. The Senate Finance Chairman is here with answers to budget questions that have us all scratching our heads. Hi, Senator. How are you?
Well, that intro is exactly right. I mean, some people, there's so much misinformation out there about what was in and what was out of the budget that I scratch my head sometimes wondering where that was from because we helped negotiate the budget. So hopefully some of the topics you get into today can clarify some of the confusion.
Yeah, there does seem to be some sort of transparency issue with the agencies. The first thing that I'm thinking about is the tax-free zone program, Startup New York, which you did not vote for. Tell us where we've come from 2014 when it was implemented.
Well, we've come from spending millions upon millions of dollars advertising this program. Come to New York and you can your business can get no taxes for 10 years, no property taxes, no income taxes, no property taxes. Your employees for 5 years get no income taxes on their salaries. And all other benefits as well. And my proposition was, how is that fair to the existing businesses and so forth? And how is this going to, how could people believe this? Well, we waited, and there was a deadline to report when the Startup New York went into effect as to what the effectiveness is. And when the report came out, there were very, very few business from out of the state of New York. Mm. There were some existing businesses that moved on to a tax-free zone. And
college campus.
And college campus, and basically, or there could be other places if they're approved, and end up getting these breaks on the promise that they're going to create a certain number of jobs. To me, and plus, the number of jobs was less than 100, and millions of dollars were given out. So there's been a lot of criticism about it, which I knew there would be. That's why I voted no. And the governor's saying, the lieutenant governor's saying, you just don't understand. Well, I understand. And it's a bad program, and it's unfair to existing businesses.
During the budget hearings, you didn't have those numbers. And you asked Ken Adams, I'd like to show that right now.
Rather than giving a complete picture, you gave no picture.
Well,
you could have gotten whatever was available, put report together.
As of.
With a little asterisk. It's not complete because we started and we didn't, all our startup stuff took time to get going and so forth.
Right.
So how is no information better than partial information? And by the way, you're still required to have it done as of the end of the year. You said it was required, but your agency delayed it. The law didn't change.
Right.
All right, so what would it take to give us what you got now so we could consider it before the budget is passed?
Well, I have this afternoon, again, first our decision was to issue a complete report as quickly as we could, and that's the decision to push it back to April 1st, to get all the data from all the companies through
the end of the year. We heard that
once. Right?
So as of December 31st, 76 jobs were created, and they spent $53 million on a national TV ad campaign.
Amazing. Amazing. How that equates to a successful program is beyond me. We did hearings, the Senate did, a couple of years ago, and what we heard across the state, I was a co-chair. Well, we heard across the state, we want across-the-board tax cuts. We shouldn't be able to pick the winners and losers, because that's dangerous as far as government picking winners and losers, and that's wrong. Everybody should benefit. And we did some tinkering with some of those cuts and some of those programs, the most successful of which was the 2% cap on school districts and local government and increasing the amount of revenues that they could obtain from the taxpayer. And there were some other things, but really, you throw $50 million here, you throw $100 million there, soon it becomes real money, and you could do some productive things across the board. And I think that's exactly what's being proven at this point in time. And unfortunately, we didn't get those numbers until late, of course, towards the end of the budget process. Most of everything had been negotiated. Mm-hmm. Everybody's chomping at the bit to get an on-time budget. And no changes were made. And I'm not saying that was intentional to keep those numbers quiet for so long, but you begin to wonder a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Another missed deadline, I-81. DOT's Joan McDonald said that you would, she would make the options available for the viaduct in Syracuse in January, and then she said March 31st. Let's watch that part of the hearing right now.
When is the your next report coming out that I thought was supposed to be January of 2015 that would outline the final list of possibilities which you'll investigate further?
It will be done this quarter, first quarter of 2015. There were some issues we've had to work through with Federal Highway on the connectivity side.
This quarter, didn't you one time say January, or am I dreaming?
I don't know if I said January at one point. Maybe
right.
I did.
All right, so now that Mark...
There seems to be a pattern here.
Yeah.
And it's like there's a deadline for this or that, or there's an expectation for this and that, and there seems to be delay after delay. And, you know, I know some of the departments are short-staffed and that sort of thing, but if you are asked when something's going to be available so the public can continue to engage in the issue, mm-hmm. you should be somewhat accurate. And now, as we tape this, I think it's the 23rd, somewhere around there, April 23rd, mm-hmm. The quarter ends, at least what I know quarters as, the end of March. Right. So it's another 3 weeks gone by and still no time in sight. Now we hear that Matt Driscoll, who used to be the mayor of the city of Syracuse, is going to be the new DOT commissioner. Now, what that's all about and what I just have no idea, but this is an important issue in Syracuse. Mm-hmm. People are interested, and if you're not going to meet deadlines, this will be going on forever, and there's got to be a solution and the right solution.
Is there another target date?
No, last we got was March 31st, and now we're going to have a new DOT commissioner. He hasn't been appointed yet, and so I'm sure it won't come out till he's appointed, and then we go on and on. But hopefully, we'll get the right decision. So it's so many different things we're dealt with. What about fracking? Mm-hmm. The fracking issue went on for 3 or 4 years. Well, we want to have enough time to make a decision. I mean, if it takes that long to make a decision, then somebody's not doing their job, or the decision is purely political. And some, as I mentioned with Startup New York, the numbers don't come out till we're near the end of the budget process. The transportation situation keeps up in limbo. Fracking, finally there was a decision, surprisingly, after the election. And I'm not so sure that was not political in order to not upset half of the people who weren't happy with the decision. So I'm not naive. I understand that politics plays a role and sometimes decisions are made. But these, when it reoccurs in all different areas, it's wrong. Mm-hmm. It's just wrong. And it's frustrating. If we're supposed to be a state that's trying to attract new business and the government can't do what they say they're going to do, then who's going to want to take a risk that the government will do what they said they would do in Startup New York? Mm-hmm. So it's a matter of credibility.
All right. And the I-81 project, this is for options. It's not even the final decision.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. I mean, then all the studies have to take place. Mm-hmm. So we'll see what happens.
All right. So you've been really getting people engaged in this. So DeFrancisco.NYsenate.gov for more information on that, as well as we'll keep our viewers updated. Mm-hmm. So another important infrastructure project that's already under construction without a financial plan is the Tappan Zee Bridge replacement project. During last year's budget hearing, you asked how it was going to get paid for, and you asked again this year. So I'd like to show a clip of the answer you got back in January.
We don't want to get too specific about a tolling plan until we know all the possible financing sources, until we had nailed down the federal piece, the EFC piece that I think we all know about, and then the settlement funds, which kind of thankfully, was manna from heaven, which a piece of that could be invested in this very important infrastructure project. I think as all of those pieces fall into place, we'll be able to come forward with a financial plan that I think will make sense to everybody.
Well, somehow I think you as budget director, if I came in and said part of the Senate budget should be a plan to build a new section to the LOB, I got a feeling you'd say, how are you going to finance it, before you said yes. Is that fair to say?
It might cross my mind.
All right, so now let me see if this might cross your mind as well. So now we're well into the project. It would seem to me that now you're chairman of the Thruway Authority, at least acting chairman. It would be a perfect time to try to say, as of this point, this is how we're going to finance it. Things change, obviously, in any project.
So there's still no financial plan.
No, and I have great respect for Bob Begna. He's been the budget director in the last few governors, the last couple at least, maybe three governors, and he's a brilliant guy. And I knew he would require a financial plan if we had requested some type of project, and I knew he wouldn't lie about it. And as he said, it would cross my mind, but it was pretty clear what he was talking about, that he would have required one. He just became acting director of the Thruway Authority. So it's very difficult for him to justify non-action in the past. But those hearings were done mostly in February, and it's now third week in April, still no financial plan. And it's almost as if we don't have the money clearly delineated. We know we have to do the project. We're going to do the project, but something's going to fall at some point where the money's going to run short. If it wasn't for these lawsuits, these settlements, lawsuits against banks, a billion more wouldn't have been found money and being used for this project. Mm-hmm. Again, it shouldn't give great confidence to our constituents of whether the state of New York is doing the right things and is planning correctly and the like. So I don't think we'll ever get a financial plan. It'll just find money somewhere to keep it going until maybe a new bond has got to be floated or something that is going to be back on the taxpayers or increases in tolls at the state fair, at the Thruway Authority. And to me, the tolls is probably the one where it's going to come in, and people are going to go crazy when those tolls all throughout the Thruway, including upstate, are being used because of a shortfall in financing, and there was never a plan.
Mm-hmm. So $1.3 billion was allocated for core capital projects with the Thruway as well as the bridge. And it was written in the budget that they have to give a plan before the funds are released. How does that work?
Well, if they want the funds and they're running short, they're going to have to give a report showing where the financing is going to come from. It's about the only club that we have. But on the other hand, that won't necessarily stop them. They've missed deadlines in the past. And I have no great comfort that they're going to let that little clause in the budget, though clear as anything, to prevent their budget director to release money. The governor was supposed to follow the statutes, but in these cases we mentioned today, they haven't.
I guess so. The last question I have is, why is it okay for these deadlines to be missed? I mean, and these are some really important things.
They're not. It's not okay. And that's why I do whatever I can, including asking these questions at budget hearings, raising the issue during the year, trying to, you know, when there's a pressure point, like, for example, someone like Robert Begna is going to be before the Senate Finance Committee at some point to be confirmed as the Thruway director, I think, or some other key, or the Transportation Department is going to get a new commissioner, Matt Driscoll. You ask the questions again, and you try to get to the point where it's embarrassing to have to answer, give the same wrong answers each year, but there's been no sign of embarrassment at this point. Our other alternative is to bring a lawsuit. If they try to release funds, bring a lawsuit, which will be costly to the taxpayers, to try to get a decision made that they have an obligation, they can't get money, they can't just spend money, they're supposed to give us the financing plan before they spend. But, you know, I don't think taxpayers really enjoy spending taxpayers' money when one branch of government's suing the other. Mm-hmm. And so that it's practicality. So we do what we can, keep the issues alive, and at some point in time, hopefully, we'll do something in the budget that's enforceable. But I'm not, first of all, I'm not here to cry. I'm not here to criticize. I'm here to just express the frustration that these things are important, they're costly, and they should be done on time.
So thank you so much for staying on top of everything and keeping us informed.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching Your Voice with Senator John DeFrancisco. We hope you join us next week for additional information and to follow along on how all the plans we talked about gets implemented. DeFrancisco.NYsenate.gov.